What's up guys, Sal here. So the first time we've seen an S Pen was back in the summer of 2011 when Samsung surprised a lot of people by launching what was then considered a massive 5.3 inch smartphone. I'm obviously talking about the original Galaxy Note, the product that is largely credited to kickstarting the phablet market. The S Pen on the original Note could detect 256 pressure points and could only be used for basic stuff such as navigating the device, grabbing screenshots using the built-in hardware button located on the top, and basic scribbling. Looking at the S Pen enabled apps that Samsung bundled on the original Galaxy Note, it is retrospectively quite obvious that the software wasn't prepared to make full use of the stylus at the moment. The original S Memo app only came with a limited number of pencils, brush and pen shapes, but it nevertheless cemented its place as an essential part of the Note brand we know and love today. Although it felt quite experimental on the original Note, the S Pen really came into its own on the Note 2. To start off, Samsung redesigned the stylus entirely, making it longer, thinner, and more ergonomic. Also, S Pen on the Note 2 could detect 1024 different levels of pressure. That's 4 times the sensitivity of the original S Pen. One of the best things about the Note 2's S Pen was the AirView feature. This allowed the users to hover the pen on top of an icon, email, or media to quickly glance at a preview without actually navigating away from their current screen. Another great feature introduced was called Easy Clip. By pressing and holding the S Pen button, users could quickly outline and crop content from virtually any screen and then pass on those crops to emails, note-taking, and image processing apps. If the S Pen button wasn't very useful on Samsung's original stylus, the situation changed for the better with the second iteration. While the pressure sensitivity remained the same, the S Pen's design underwent a drastic overhaul and now featured a squarish, symmetrical design. This meant you could now store the S Pen in its slot without having to fiddle around for the right side. The biggest and best change though was the addition of the Air command menu, which brought the main S Pen functionality together in a single half-circle menu that would appear anytime you ejected the stylus. Thankfully, for those that were turned on by the Note series but turned off by the price, Samsung released a stripped-back version of the Galaxy Note 3 called the Note 3 Neo. Despite an overall drop in power, the Neo came with all of the same S Pen features found on its premium counterpart. When it comes to the S Pen and its features, the Note 4 was more of an iterative upgrade. The best new feature was undeniably Smart Select, which made it possible to select text on a website or document. This made the S Pen truly feel like a PC mouse for the first time, as it could copy and paste lines of a text with just a few gestures and taps on the S Pen. With the Note 5, Samsung continued improving on the S Pen hardware by making the pen longer, thinner, and smoother. Samsung took the necessary decision to strip out much of the unnecessary features from its S Pen Ready suite. The Air command menu also went through a design overhaul to match Samsung's then custom skin TouchWiz's new look and added the option to edit which apps appear in the menu. Also, users managed to get their S Pen stuck by inserting it into the phone backwards. This problem has been often referred to as the PenGate scandal. Fortunately, Samsung later rolled out a quick production line fix to make sure that the stylus doesn't fit when inserted the wrong way. Samsung upped the S Pen pressure sensitivity once again to a whopping 4096 and made it water resistant, making it feasibly possible to draw underwater or, as was likely more common, use the pen in the rain. You also now couldn't put the S Pen in the phone backwards, so no more PenGate problems at least. It also got some software upgrades. The most notable was Animation Select, which let users record 15 seconds GIFs by drawing out a frame with the stylus. Despite the major design shift of the phone, Samsung took a relatively cautious approach and kept the design and basically functionality of the S Pen intact. The notable changes came in the software department, where productivity was once again a key focus. Translate could now translate full sentences and not just individual words. It also had screen off memos, and there was also the addition of live message for making animated GIFs out of recorded stylus text, effects, and images to share with friends and family. The Note 9's S Pen represents an evolutionary milestone for the Note series stylus. The introduction of Bluetooth support is a revelation, letting users utilize the S Pen as a remote control for all manner of regular smartphone functions. This includes opening the camera, switching between regular photos or selfies, control music playback, flip through presentation slides, and much more. All in all, the Note 9 S Pen is the next logical step in the stylus's progression, and I can't wait to see where it goes next. That being said, let me know your thoughts on this down in the comments, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Peace out.
We do not speak his name.
Okay.